Good morning, all of you. I am very happy to participate in this online talk about Buttresses of Kerala. Sharon already introduced me. I am conducting studies about birds, butterflies, and dragonflies of Kerala. And the founder of Warblers and Waders, Natural Lovers Group, active in Kerala since 1990. Now associate with Peter Smetachek's Butterfly Research Center at BIMDA. Okay, thank you everybody. Now we can start to the talk. Then butterflies of Kerala. Kerala have, I think, 327. Now it is increasing 344. Then the welcome slide is the largest butterfly seen in India's southern belt. Kerala physical map, physiographical features of Kerala, highlands up to 2,700 meters, midlands 800 to 1,500 meters, lowlands sea level 150 meters. Kerala total 38,863 kilometers and is situated between the Arabian Sea to the west and the Western Ghats to the east. Then 5580 kilometer length and 3520 kilometer in width approximately. Kerala divides into divided into highlands, eastern highlands, central midlands, and the western lowlands, located at the extreme or southern tip of the Indian subcontinent. In Kerala climate and seasons. Then diverse geography of Kerala. Climate is also diverse. It is a tropical and a generally pleasant climate. The high ranges in Kerala is cool throughout the year, but plains experience hot and humid during the summer months. Annual temperature range comparatively low in Kerala, that is 32 and minimum 22 degrees Celsius. Three major seasons in Kerala: summer February to May, monsoon June August, and October November. Winter December January. Rainfall in Kerala, the total rainfall is in the state is approximately 360 centimeter and northern parts of Kerala, and 160 centimeter approximately in southern part of Kerala. Monsoon summer showers at before April, after May, or starting from April with thunder showers, and it continues its monsoon at June. This call in Kerala we call it as Edavapadi. Then rainfall during northeast monsoon season is in October, November, we call it as Tula Varsham. Forest diversity of Kerala, dense evergreen forest, open forest, moist and dry deciduous forest, scrub forest, very little scrub forest in Kerala, in Chinnar Wildlife Sanctuary and Palakkad district, some places of Palakkad district and Attapadi. Then mangroves, backwaters and very good biodiversity areas. Then Meristica swamp is a special that is seen in South India, South Kerala only. And Meristica swamp, freshwater swamp inside the evergreen forest. It is a very high biodiversity spot. Then again, defined into types of forest of Kerala: semi-evergreen forest or west coast semi-evergreen forest, transition stage between evergreen and moist deciduous forest, southern hilltop tropical forest. This inferior variety of typical evergreen forest, maximum height of only 10 meter. Then west coast tropical evergreen forest, it is a dense evergreen forest and lofty tree 45 meter or more higher. This is the most, then we can see the rare and endemic species in this tropical evergreen forest: butterflies, birds, mammals and reptiles also. Wet evergreen and semi-evergreen climax forest in Kerala. This is Western Ghats. There are rainfall is above 250 meter millimeter. Then biodiversity of Kerala. Then Kerala is a high biodiversity spots in the world. Then Western Ghats is also high hotspot. Then Kerala is a part of it. Midlands, foothills, plains, coastal belt, also rich biodiversity place. tropical rainforest, shola forest, Verestica sams, and highly endemic biodiversity. Then total biodiversity, then angiosperms 4,575, fern and fernalis 329, bryophytes 228, lichens 428, algae 866, mammoths 132, birds 483, butterflies 327, 344 is the western guards, dragonflies 150, reptiles 156, amphibians 93, Indian fishes 282, and invertebrates 5,300 plus. Butterfly hotspots of Kerala. In Kerala, so many butterfly hotspots, but and here I only mentioned about 8 spots conducting butterfly surveys and studies. Chandrini Wildlife Sanctuary, 253 species. Silent Valley National Park, 201 in recent survey, but I think it is more, 250 plus also. Wardchild Reserve Forest, 223 species. It studies with Rajasri during the year 2000 to 2012. And Warbless Invaders also conducting some butterfly surveys there. Wayanad Wildlife Sanctuary, 222 species in recent survey conducted by ferns. Idukki Wildlife Sanctuary, 111 by Warbless Invaders, and much above recently conducted surveys in 225 by TNHS. Aripa Reserve Falls, 235 species. Chinnar Wildlife Sanctuary, TNHS, I think it is 260 species. Pepara and Nayar Wildlife Sanctuary, TNHS, I think it is also 250, 260. They are conducting annual surveys there. Then another one is Nilambur Wildlife Division is also very rich in high butterfly species, right? Thattekarpet Sanctuary and other places also. In this picture, you can see the rare and endemic species, Travancore Evening Brown, and another rare only seen in Kerala, that is the pump. Sorry. Oh, you can remember the name. Now, some habitats I can show you. Augusta Golden Peak. It is a tropical montane forest and very wet evergreen forest. And you can see the endemic butterfly species, Nilgiri foraging, Palani foraging, and the such endemic, reddish bush brown, and other endemic species also. This is the open forest. Open forest is very good for butterfly activities. In sunny areas are more attractive butterflies. I think more species in this open forest and mixed forest. In this again, grasslands and shola forest. Grasslands are very good for some typical butterflies, some silver line, some then oak blues, some already show you Nilgiri foraging, etc. Now, lowland evergreen forest. This is Aripa. Lowland evergreen forest of Kerala is very rich in butterfly scents. Then Thattekarpet Bird Sanctuary is also the same habitat of lowland evergreen forest. It is also a very, very good place for butterfly watchers. Now it is riverine. You know, in summer months, then butterfly watchers and butterfly lovers are very like to visit our riverine for see mud puddling, thousands of mud puddling, swallowtails, whites, and other species. Now early documentation of butterflies of Kerala. Then in early De Villiers, Butterflies of India, Burma, and Ceylon, 3 volumes, mentioned about the butterflies of Kerala. Then in Malabar Manual, William Logan's Malabar Manual, including checklist of 130 species of butterflies seen in North Kerala, the checklist prepared by R. Morgan. Then a list of butterflies by Ferguson, 1891, contained 220 butterfly species seen in South Kerala. Now, current documentation of butterflies of Kerala, so many documentation of butterflies about in Kerala in recently. Then butterfly, talking about first reason, Kerala Thile Chitra Shalabangal, a series written by Suresh Alaman in Madhribhumi is the first butterfly documentation in Kerala in 1982-88. It gave the way to the butterfly watching in Kerala. Otherwise, bird watching is very popular in Kerala. After 1988, Suresh Laman's Kerala Thile Chitra Shalabangal leads to butterfly watching in Kerala. The same time, Common Butterflies of India by Isaac Kahimkar, some South Indian butterflies by T.N.A. Perumal and other co-authors also then leads to butterfly watching in Kerala. In 1990s, very good number of butterfly watches in Kerala, and now increasing day by day. Then Butterfly India meets, I think all Butterfly Meets India meets in Kerala was conducted by Warblers Invaders. First Butterfly India meet conducted in 2005 with Butterfly India Yahoo groups led by Kishan Das and Krishna Mekunde. Chandruni Wildlife Sanctuary. Again, we conducted a butterfly survey at Butterfly Meet at Chandruni Wildlife Sanctuary during the year 2007. This is also led by Krishna Mekunde. I think 133 butterfly species found in that meet. Then Butterfly Meet again conducted by Warblers Invaders 2015 at Warachal. 190 butterflies, very high. Then Peter Smetacek, Butterfly Research Center founder member and director, led the survey. And we can able to find blue nabob, a very rare butterfly in this meet. And again, Aripa and then Chandruni Wildlife Sanctuary, again, we conducted a butterfly survey during the year 2007. Butterfly surveys every year since, I think, 2000, butterfly survey conducted in forest area by different NGOs. Then very good support from Kerala Forest Department in the survey. Very nice support by them. Aralang Wildlife Sanctuary annual butterfly survey conducted by Malabar Nature Society, Kannur. Parambikulam Wildlife Sanctuary annual butterfly survey conducted by Fern Wynard. Idiki Wildlife Sanctuary butterfly survey conducted by Warblers Invaders and TNHS. Chandruni Pepara Nayar Wildlife Sanctuary annual butterfly survey conducted by Tamkur Nature Society. Silent Valley National Parks butterfly survey conducted by Malabar Nature Society, Kozhikode. Wynard Life Sanctuary butterfly survey conducted by Fern Wynard. Nelambur Butterfly Survey and other places also conducting butterfly surveys. I think in South Kerala, Kerala is leading in conducting butterfly studies and butterfly surveys. Now, total number of butterflies. India, 1318. Sri Lanka, 450 species. Nepal, 640 species. Pakistan, 450 species. Northeast, 1,000 species. Kerala and Western Ghats, 344 species. Uttarakhand, 450 species. Malabar banded peacock, beautiful butterfly endemic to Western Ghats, is the state butterfly of Kerala. It is recently announced. Then two other contestants also in this contest. That is Malabar trainee fan, Malabar banded solitaire. But at last, we considered Malabar banded peacock as the state butterfly of Kerala. Now butterfly species, species level. You can see the butterfly family, six families, Aspidae skippers, Papilionidae solitaires, Pieridae whites and aloes, Rainidae, Rhaenodinidae, Judies and punches, Lysinidae blues, Nymphalidae brush-footed butterflies. Now Hesperidae, then very, it is an overview, then I can show only you very few species within this time limit. Then Hesperidae is the very difficult species to some swifts and some darts are very difficult to identify, very fast flying butterflies. Golden tree feeder, it is the endemic butterfly, somewhat rare butterfly species seen in Western Ghats, also seen in Kerala. Another bicolor is, I think, more rare than golden tree feeder. It is very difficult to come ground. Most of this time it's spent in the canopy. That may be the reason for it is considered as a rare species, bicolor ace. It's this tumble grass art, very common endemic species seen in grasslands and open forest. Higher elevation forest, we can see seen in very commonly. Now, large branded swift. I already told you, brand swift species are very difficult to ID. Now, it is restricted domain. You can see the long proboscis of this butterfly. How can it suck nectar from the flower? This is the restricted domain. When the same, very very similar species, common banded domain seen in some well-wooded regions and city areas also. It having three apical spots on its forewing. That is the only difference that we can seen from restricted domain. This is a very common species seen in forest, cities and towns also, common palm dart. Tumble spotted flat. Identifying spotted flat is also little difficult with some spots on its forewing. This is Tamil spotted flat, endemic to Western Ghats. Now we enter to the second family, Papilionidae, solitaires, very beautiful butterflies in the butterfly world. Most of the butterflies have some small long tails on its hind wings. Southern blue bottle, it is endemic to southern India. In northern India, we can see the common blue bottle. This have southern blue bottle have little tail on its hindwing. That is the difference. This is the some comparison of two similar species, southern blue bottle and common jay. Common jay is whitish, but when its wings open, it is also color similar to but blue bottle. Some more in our early stages of butterfly watching, misidentifying common jay with southern blue bottle. That is tailed jay. It's very difficult to get a good shot. Very fast flying, hovering, very fast fluttering. Then very few times it only most of the time it is a restless butterfly, but very beautiful butterfly. Common butterfly seen in cities and rural urban areas also. Sports swallowtail. In Kerala, it is seen only in dry deciduous or moist deciduous forest. Not more common in southern Kerala. Fiber swallowtail, little rare in forest species seen in wet evergreen forest. But in summer months, we can see 10 plus or 50 plus fiber swallowtail mud puddling with other swallowtail butterflies and whites. This is Malabar rose, another beautiful endemic butterfly to Western Ghats, seen in Kerala in some local patches, not common. Now it is blue woman, maybe considered as the second largest butterfly seen in Kerala. This way fairly common in all habitat, except extreme dry climate. This common banded peacock, then we have Malabar banded peacock, our state butterfly. Now another Paris peacock is also evergreen species. Now common banded peacock is a dry species, seen in dry deciduous forest, moist deciduous forest, not seen in evergreen or semi-evergreen forest in Kerala. Most common in northern Kerala, very little rare in South Kerala. This is the southern bedwing. Then Kerala, we have lucky to have the largest butterfly in India, southern bedwing, and smallest butterfly in India, grass jewel. Southern bedwing is very common in semi-evergreen, evergreen forest, now in the cities and urban areas also. Now next family, Pieridae, yellows and whites, small butterflies, colors yellows and white color. Three-spot grass yellow. This is the common species seen in forest region, but another species also very similar to the common grass yellow is also very similar. Then three-spot grass yellow is different. It have three spots in the forewing, and common grass yellow have two spots. So small grass yellow seen in the higher elevations forest and our hilltops grasslands. Dark wanderer. It is also a wet evergreen or semi-evergreen forest. You can see it. Not common. Only seen in forest. Chocolate arbutus, a very common species seen in forest, open forest, wetlands, and other clearings also. Most beautiful butterflies seen in our yellows and whites in Kerala. And so painted sartus seen in Tamil Nadu is also one of the beautiful painted jessibel is also very beautiful, but not seen in Kerala. This is common jessibel seen in all habitats. Striped albatross, it is like to dry habitats, on dry wetlands habitats and in dry deciduous forest. This is one of the rare white species seen in Kerala. Sport puffin, but in northeast it is very common, northeast states, but in Kerala it is Western Ghats, a little rare. It is only seen in higher elevation tropical montane forest. Then Ridinoidea, we have only one species only, Plum Judy. Then in another north, Punjas and also, but Kerala only Plum Judy is the only member. Now Lycaenidae, Lycaenidae blues, it is also small butterflies with some tufty tails or small tails, tiny tails on its hind wings. This is angled pair seen in forest region and well-wooded region. Common pair is seen in cities also. This is a forest dweller, only seen in forest areas, blue banded pair. The banded is little different from angled pair and common pair. When it opens its wing, its blue color is very prominent than angled pair and common pair. This is fluffy tip, very nice butterfly with fluffy tails. And most of the butterfly watchers are like to see this tiny butterfly. Now it is red spot. Then one important thing to then this type of blue butterflies are they are the caterpillars attended by ants. This female expert is trying to egg-laying when it saw a group of red ants roaming around it. Then some smell, pheromone smell get it, the ant and ant touches its tail. But I not get a chance to photograph the egg-laying of female. This orchid is little rare in Kerala. Most of the time, it spend in the higher elevation, that may be the reason in the canopy. But in northeast and northern India, North India, it is very common. Banded royal, somewhat rare, seasonally seen only in Kerala, not seen in all season. In wet, very wet patches, you can see banded royal. Young fly, that is also a very nice butterfly with tiny tails. You can see the caterpillar with ants on the same picture. Then these are also licking some sweet from this tiny tender of this this leaf. Now oriental grass jewel. Then it is a grass jewel is the smallest. Oriental grass jewel is the same size. It may be also one of the smallest butterflies seen in Kerala. Oriental grass jewel seen in dry areas. Now we enter to the another family, Nymphalidae, brush-footed butterflies. Its front legs are not large and brush. It can use it to find its food plants and collecting some mineral plants. Common leopard, very common in evergreen forest, semi-evergreen forest, and well-wooded regions. Not seen in cities. Tamil yeoman, it is the state butterfly of Tamil Nadu. The same time, it is also very common in Kerala. It is very common in Kerala. In olden days, in my childhood, it is also seen in my residence area. But recently, in lockdown days, it again come back to my residence, Tamil yeoman. This beautiful, now the beautiful butterfly in the Nymphalidae family, Cruiser, then yellow color, golden yellow color. Most of the time, it like to basking, then mud puddling, and taking, licking liquids from then the cow dung. Then another animal excreta. It's a very beautiful butterfly of Nymphalidae family. Then blue nawab, this rather uncommon butterfly seen in Kerala. Then Warblers and Wedders research team can able to discover the new food plant Bohemia fornica from Panmudi Hills during the year 2010, and it is published in the Journal of Bohemian Society. Now it is also very difficult to find in the field. Now the rainy season is the most abundant season of this blue nawab. Okay, painted lady is the common butterfly seen in higher elevations. When I start my butterfly watching during the year 1989, it is only seen in the higher elevation forest. But nowadays, last two or three years, it changes its habitat. Now some range extension. Now it is seen in wetlands of Trivandrum also. Punjakari wetlands, Trivandrum city, four or five sightings from Trivandrum city. It may be due to some climatic change. Bluebirds are also seen in wet forest, or most of the time seen in riverine forest. Water-loving butterflies seen in near waterfalls, etc. Evergreen forest also. Common maple is also seen in wet evergreen forest. Not common in other areas. Most of the time spent in the forest revolutes and small streams and rivers and waterfalls. Very very nice butterfly. Common striped tiger, or common tiger, or striped tiger. This is very common seen in open forest. Dark blue tiger, common in forest area. Mud puddling with and collecting minerals from common crows, double branded crow, and blue tiger. It's common crow. It is very common butterfly seen in. Now, double branded crow is difficult to identify from common crow. It is when it closes its wings, it is very similar. But when it opens wing, you can see two male with two brands. And when it closes its wings, you can see a row of three white spots on the forewing. These are the identification markings of common crow, double banded crow, common crow. But we need little experience to watch these two butterflies. Malabar trainee, one of the most slow flying butterflies seen in Kerala. Malabar trainee is endemic species butterfly. I had an opportunity to find this new host plant from Meristica Sams of Chanthurini Wildlife Sanctuary and IPA. This is the color sturgeon. Color sturgeon is also not common in Kerala forest. In South Kerala, North Kerala, it is little common. In South Kerala, very rare. Occasionally, we can see it. Clipper is the very common forest butterfly species seen in evergreen and moist deciduous forest and semi-evergreen forest of Kerala. Very large butterfly, very fast flying. Male and female have different coloration. This is the male. Peacock pansy. This is most loving in wetland areas, and its foot plant is also seen in wetland. That may be the reason for very common in wetlands. Seen in some open forest also. Share with blue the another pansies. Travancore evening brown, one of the rare species, locally common, but not seen in everywhere. It is seen in red thickets. Aclantra species its foot plant. That may be the risk, but not seen in all red thickets. Some special patches in Trivandrum, it's seen in Kallar Panmadi Hill, some red patches, and Chanthurini Wildlife Sanctuary and Pepara Wildlife Sanctuary, and then in Aripa, in Valchal, but not seen in all red thickets. I don't know the reason for it, but in this red thickets, we can see easily find male and female butterflies during monsoon season. Monsoon is the main season of the setting of Travancore evening brown. Now pumpkin. Pumpkin also only set up from Kerala. It is the very nice butterfly seen in Pepara Wildlife Sanctuary, Chanthurini Wildlife Sanctuary, Kallar Panmudi Hills, and Aripa Forest. These are the only recorded setting places from Kerala. Pumpkin is a rare one, and I think Sanders Verghese is study the biology of pumpkin from Tenmala Butterfly Park. Tamil Catsey is also an interesting endemic species seen in wet forest. It is also seasonal, seen in pre-monsoon, post-monsoon, and between summer showers. After that, not seen Tamil Catsey. Red is bush brown. It is also an endemic butterfly species seen in Western Ghats and seen in Kerala. This butterfly is only seen in higher elevation forest, in Shola forest, not seen in lower elevation forest. In Shola forest, there is plenty of red disc bush brown we can see, but in lower elevation, we cannot see in this endemic butterfly species. Glade bush brown. It is also a forest species. Not seen in rural areas. Evergreen, semi-evergreen, moist evergreen forest. Very common species during monsoon season. Now the butterfly species ending an overall view. Now some butterfly activities. Butterflies are more likely to, male butterflies are like to mudpuddling during summer months. Then butterfly congregation see in collecting minerals from some plants. Basking during daytime. Then another is feeding nectar. These are the butterfly activities. Now another, then butterfly courtship, male and female before mating, then mating, then oviposing, egg laying of southern birdwing in an Archilochia species. Sorry, Tortia silicosa species, endemic plant. Now you can see the early stages of butterflies. First is egg of southern birdwing. Second is eggs of Travancore evening brown. Third is the caterpillar of Malabar rose and pupa of Malabar rose. Then eggshells are the first meal of a caterpillar. When it emerges from an egg, the caterpillar eats the eggshells. Maybe escape from predators. Then first is the Travancore evening brown caterpillar eats eggshell. Second is the newly hatched southern duffer caterpillars eating eggshells. Then another is molting of caterpillar. Then five instars, the caterpillar molting into another stage, enter to another stage. That is a molting caterpillar of tawny coaster. Then another very nice experience to watch the caterpillars of this Hesperiidae species. Some are making cells, some have different types of cells. This macular transferis made a very nice cell with some. It can open it like a door, and when you feel it not good or predators seen, then it shut and inside the cell. Macular transferis is also very very rare species seen in Kerala. This is the two sides life cycle of two rare butterflies seen in Kerala. First is the life cycle of palm king. Then I am very grateful to Sandus Varghese to share the life cycle experience in Tenmala Butterfly Park. Now second is the blue nawab. I am grateful to my teammates of Warblers Invaders. Then in our Ponmudi study trip, we can see the caterpillars of blue nawab. And later, then we can find the new food plant for it also, a new record. Now, predators or enemies of butterflies. Then I am a bird lover, the same time, the butterfly lover also. The birds are the most important predators of butterflies, especially in breeding season. The butterfly is the main feed for to their chicks. This is the Nilgiri flycatcher with Nilgiri tiger. Then ashy solar shrike with blue tiger butterfly. Then another, we never expect a dragonfly is the predator of a butterfly. Yes, this is the green marshhawk with common evening brown. Then dragonflies are also predating butterflies. Then last one is the spider. Spider is also a predator of or enemy of butterfly. Then praying mantis in the early stages of egg and caterpillar. Praying mantis is one of the important predator of butterflies. Then snails are also enemies of butterfly early stages. Now the life cycle of southern birdie, largest butterfly in India. Its food plants is Aristolochia species, three or more species of Aristolochia species, and other species of some wild varieties of Aristolochia also the food plant of southern birdie. Then butterfly threats, habitat loss, habitat degradation, indiscriminate usage of pesticides are the main threats to the butterflies of Kerala and butterflies of Western Ghats, or other butterflies of India. Then butterfly means really helpful to butterfly watchers of Kerala very lot, especially the experts like Krishnamekunda, Kishan Das, Peter Smetachak share their butterfly discoveries and butterfly experience with students. Many students participated in this butterfly meets conducted by Warblers Invaders. Then nowadays, so many butterfly experts in Kerala, Balakrishnan Valappil, B.C. Balakrishnan, Suresh Elaman, E. Kunjikrishnan, Dr. S. Kalesh, so many youngsters, Prem Krishnan and S.S. Anujan, Warblers Invaders. Now so many youngsters are also coming to this field and more findings, tufted. Supplier, then so many new species from our butterfly surveys, then brown onyx, so many new records from these butterfly surveys and meets. So it is really very nice for butterfly watchers of Kerala, and I am very happy to share my experience with you all in this online talk, where I am thank you to Sharan and the organizers to organize this butterfly talk. Thank you very much to all of you to hearing my butterfly talk for this long 35 or 40 minutes. Thank you so much.